Gastrointestinal secretion can be classified into salivary secretion. Salivary secretion meaning secretion of saliva. Secretion of saliva is done in the mouth and have many functions. The first one initiated of starch digestion by alpha amylase or tylene, and initiated triglyceride digestion by lingual lipase. The second one is lubrication of the ingested food in order to be easily to swallowed by the mucus. The third one is a protection because the saliva contain high quantity of water that lead to make mixture more neutral pH, therefore protect the mouth and oesophagus from irritation by dilution and buffering of ingested foods. Gastric secretion is done in the stomach and achieved by three types of the cell located in different parts of the stomach. The stomach parts is classified into three parts, which are: first is fundus, located just after the esophagus, and the second part is the extended part, is the, which called a body, and the last part is fundus. The cells responsible for gastric secretion are: first, parietal cell located in the body, and fundus responsible for secretion of HCl and intrinsic factor, control via the vagal stimulation by acetylcholine, also by the other hormone like gastrin and histamine. The second one is chief cell located also in the body and fundus, responsible for secretion of pepsinogen, which are converted to pepsin at low pH, controlled via vagal stimulation also by acetylcholine neurotransmitter. The G cell located in the antrum and responsible for secretion of gastrin, controlled via vagal stimulation mediated by gastric releasing peptide. Also, there are other type of the cell responsible for secretion of mucus called mucus cell. Mechanism of gastric acid secretion. Parietal cell secreted HCl into the lumen of the stomach and concurrently absorbed HCO3 into the bloodstream as follows. In the parietal cell, CO2, H2O are converted to H and HCO3 catalyzed by carbonic anhydrase. H+ is secreted into the lumen of the stomach by hydrogen potassium pump, hydrogen potassium ATPase. Chloride is secreted along with hydrogen, thus the secretion product of parietal cell is HCl. The HCO3 product in the cell is absorbed into bloodstream in exchange for chloride bicarbonate exchange, as bicarbonate is added to the venous blood. The pH of the blood increased, that called alkaline tide. Eventually, this bicarbonate will be secreted into pancreatic secretion to neutralize hydrogen in the small intestine. Stimulation of gastric HCl secretion. As mentioned before, the HCl are secreted by the parietal cell located in the fundus and body of the stomach, that control via vagal stimulation. Vagal stimulation increases hydrogen secretion by a direct pathway and an indirect pathway. In the direct pathway, the vagus nerve innervates parietal cell and stimulates hydrogen secretion directly. The neurotransmitter at these synapses is acetylcholine. The receptor on the parietal cell is muscarinic, and the second messenger is IP3 and increase intracellular calcium. In the indirect pathway, the vagal nerve innervation G-cell and stimulate gastric secretion, which then stimulate hydrogen secretion by endocrine action. The neurotransmitter for this mechanism is gastric releasing peptide. The hormone control HCL secretion are: first, histamine is released from mast cell in the gastric mucosa and diffused to the nearby parietal cell. Stimulate hydrogen secretion by activation of H2 receptor on the parietal cell membrane. The second messenger of this process is cyclic AMP. Gastrin is the second hormone control secretion of the HCL. Is released in response to the eating a meal, small peptide, distension of the stomach, and lead to the vagal stimulation. Stimulation of hydrogen secretion by interacting with the unidentified receptor on the parietal cell. The second messenger for gastrin on parietal cell has not been identified till now, but is clearly different from acetylcholine and histamine because their action are additive with those of gastrin. Pancreatic secretion contains a high concentration of bicarbonate, whose purpose is to neutralize the acidic chyme that reaches to the duodenum. Contain enzymes essential for the digestion of protein, carbohydrate, and fat. Stimulation of pancreatic secretion is done by first, secretin is secreted by the HCL of the duodenum in response to the hydrogen in the duodenal lumen. Act on the pancreatic ductal cell to increase bicarbonate secretion. Thus, when hydrogen is delivered from the stomach to the duodenum, secretin is released as a result of the bicarbonate is secreted from the pancreas into the duodenal lumen to neutralize the hydrogen. The second messenger of this process is cyclic AMP. CCK is secreted by the I cell of the duodenum in response to the small peptide, amino acid, and fatty acid in the duodenal lumen. Act on the pancreatic acinar cell to increase enzyme secretion, amylase, lipase, and protease. Potentiate the effect of secretin on the ductal cell to stimulate bicarbonate secretion. The second messenger for CCK is IP3 and increase intracellular calcium. Also, acetylcholine is released in response to the hydrogen, small peptide, amino acid, and fatty acid in the duodenal lumen. Stimulates enzyme secretion by the acinar cell and, like CCK, potentiate the effect of secretin on the bicarbonate secretion. Bile secretion and gallbladder function. bile contain bile salt, phospholipid cholesterol, and bile pigment, which called bilirubin. Bile salts are amphipathic molecules because they have both hydrophobic and hydrophilic portion. In aqueous solution, bile salts orient themselves around the droplet of liquid and keep the lipid droplet dispersed, which called emulsification, aid in the initial digestion and absorption of lipid by emulsifying and solubilizing them in micelles. Now, what are the micelles? Above the critical micellar concentration, bile salt form micelles. Bile salts are positioned on the outside of the micelles with their hydrophilic portion dissolved in the aqueous solution of the initial lumen and their hydrophobic portion dissolved in the micelle interior. Free fatty acid and monoglycerides are present in the inside of the micelles, essentially solubilized for the subsequent absorption. Now, formation of bile. Bile is produced continuously by the hepatocytes. Bile drain into the hepatic ducts and stored in the gallbladder for subsequent release. Bile is formed by the following process: primary bile acid, cholic acid, and genodeoxycholic acid are synthesized from cholesterol by hepatocyte. In the intestine, bacteria convert portion of each the primary bile acid to secondary bile acid. Deoxycholic acid and lethocholic acid synthesis of new bile acid occur as needed to replace the bile that are excreted in the feces. The bile acid are conjugated with the glycine or taurine to form their respective bile salts, which are named for the parent bile acid. For example, taurocholic acid is cholic acid conjugated with taurine. Electrolytes and water are added to bile during the interdigestive period. The gallbladder relaxes and the sphincter of OD is closed and the gallbladder filled with bile. Bile is concentrated in the gallbladder as a result of the isoosmotic absorption of solutes and water. Presence of certain substances that lead to the contraction of gallbladder, which are first CCK. CCK is released in response to the presence of small peptides and fatty acids in the duodenum. Tells the gallbladder that bile acid is needed to emulsify and absorb lipids in the duodenum, cause contraction of the gallbladder and relaxation of sphincter of OD. Second factor is acetylcholine. Acetylcholine causes also contraction of gallbladder and secretion of its continent in the duodenum.